What's up, Internet? This is Random Game Critic, and welcome back to Hollow Knight. In the last episode, we defeated Hornet for a second time and got the King's Brand. We got marked by the King's Brand somewhere in here, probably. Yes, there it is. Marks the bearer as king. Hollow Nest's ancient places shall be opened before it. So, with that vague-ass description, we're going to use it, because I know where it is. Press the glowing button, of course. Hit the glowing red button. Wait, it's not red. Whatever. Back to Ancient Basin. Actually, this is a place that we just literally discovered, like, just a couple of videos ago. So we're actually gonna explore what it is now. There's a sealed door with the mark of, because the king had kind of sort of has a symbol. It's like that kind of trident with the four forks on it. I mean, I think it's actually like right there. That's like the king's universal symbol. That symbol was like on the door, and like there's a sign next to it that I read. I didn't read it out loud, but something along the lines of like, our pure vessel has ascended. Behind is just the regrets of its creation. We shall enter that place no longer. That actually might be exactly what it said, word for word. I'll double check that. Ouch, spikes. Why are there just spikes everywhere? Like, I mean, obviously it's because video game, but like with a game that's like has worlds as detailed as Hollow Nest. Well, I guess there are some things that are still just because video game. Like, same reason why there's spikes in the elevators in the City of Tears. Like, there's no logical reason for that. It's just because video game. How close was I? Higher beings, these words are for you alone. I forgot that line. Always forgot about that line. Our pure vessel has ascended. Beyond lies only the refuse and regret of its creation. We shall enter that place no longer. But now we have the King's Brand, we can enter inside. And here we go. There's just no music here. Just a lot of kind of swirling black clouds of nothingness. Something very interesting off to the left side of the screen here that we can't get yet, but it's a thing that is here, though. A deep blue stone atop a dais. I'm actually not sure how it's pronounced, actually. But anyways, basically, we're just going to fall all the way down this. I think there's a couple of geocaches along the way, but I can't be bothered to search for all of them. Okay, there's one at least. There's nothing important in this room. Oh, I just realized I've never even tried to use the freaking charge slash yet. I was holding down the attack button on accident, and I started glowing, and I was like, wait, what was that? Oh yeah, right, I have a thing that I haven't used yet. There's no real good place to use it here either, that's for sure. I'm gonna ignore all these. Okay, we're seeing some skulls now, some very familiar looking skulls. Kinda looks similar to mine. And we're at the bottom. Welcome to the Abyss. This is... It's weird the fact that I'm playing through this game and I'm not explaining any of the story when these are huge things that are happening here. Oh crap, okay, nope, whoop. You can totally kill those things, like, they're not invincible or anything, as it was implied by the fact that I just immediately ran away, but, I just didn't want to, I left. Okay, didn't think so. I'd be very interested in, like, what these creatures that aren't even, like, were never sentient, what their thoughts were. Nothing, sounds about right. I think there's nothing even over here I can get right now. Nothing even over here I can get right now. Unless, do I have this move? No, I don't have that move. Okay, nope. But I think there's a little clue on what you can do here. Our voices will cry out again. So, something related to voices. Like, maybe, howling? that's your clue. We don't have the move, though. Anyways, back in here, we're gonna deal with, that shade-like thing, that's just like what happens with those things that appear when I die. But there's other ones now. We'll probably see others. Yeah, there's one. So these things, not hard to kill, but they can gang up on you. You gotta make sure that doesn't happen, because if they do, these things take out two pieces of health. Yep, there it is. I thought I could dream nail it. I was really curious. Oh, that's interesting. Okay, that's way too risky, though. Also, there's a problem that you don't get soul back from these things, because it seems like they don't have soul, which is interesting. But yeah, okay, don't touch those. Also, that's just badness. They'll just deal one mask of damage, but still, just, you know, that's damage. Look at those. Those don't look like friendly things you should be running your face into. I just noticed the vines hanging from the ceiling actually move when you walk past them. Also. How was this a Kickstarter game? Alright. Now, I think these things, more than anything else, like, you want to just kill them as you go. Because I have, like, seriously, even in recent playthroughs where I know this game, I've made the mistake of just not doing that and just running past them all because I got impatient. And they, because these things, when they're after you, they chase you forever. So if you get a whole trail of them to gang up on you, like, you are in, like, serious trouble. Like that has killed me before, even in recent playthroughs. Because a lot of them can sneak up on you, and they all do double damage, and they don't leave you alone. Okay, probably a good thing I fell down here, because there was a third one up there that would have followed me down here as well if I had made that jump. Alright, come on, one at a time. Okay. Oh boy. Okay, good. They could have flanked me from a different direction, but they didn't. Have very nice of my siblings to do that for me. By the way, that is their canonical name. See? Siblings. I kind of do want to just defeat eight more just to see, like, what they're all about. I probably will by the time I even get up this stupid lighthouse. Whoop. Well, that was close. There's actually a charm that makes it so, like, you don't get knocked back when you hit things with your nail. And I found it, like, distracting when I put the thing on one time. Like, it was... Like, the game played so differently, it was, like... It was messing me up with how different the game felt when I didn't get pushed back whenever I hit something. Yeah, I think this... Actually, no, this doesn't get rid of the siblings, no. Turn it off? Cannot. My king, I'm sorry, the sea calls. Yeah, I totally know what that means. It's because we're in a kingdom of bugs, so it's like a bunch of little fireflies. Actually, I think those are lumaflies, actually, technically, because like the same thing that's in the lantern and some other stuff in a later area we'll see soon. Fairly soon. Well, I mean, it will be actually that'll pretty much be like after I finish this area. We're gonna go hunt down the dreamers after that. So I believe, actually, I've never even tried to go, like, beyond this point. I think that there's the Sea of Blackness here. There's just a bunch of tentacles. If you don't turn the light on, when the light is on, then you can cross through it safely. I've actually never tried crossing that before without turning the light on. I've actually never tried doing that without the light on. I don't know what it does. There's a very, very bullshit secret in here somewhere that I also want to make sure that I find. Isn't super important, but it's part of a journal that, like, I always forget about. I think the upward? No, it's the downward route is the way we can't go. Yep, that's correct. Okay, so can't go over there. Yeah, up here where the light's coming in through. Yep, okay. Oh, I need to freaking... Okay, can't even go in there yet. Alright, well, in case it wasn't obvious, we're going to be getting the ability to get through there, like, in, like, the next, like, 30 seconds. Probably gotta hit its face. Alright. Let's take a little bath. And I can't move. The Shade Cloak. What did I call this thing? Is that what I called it? I think I might have called it like the Shadow Cloak or something like that. I forgot what I kept calling it, but Shade Cloak, that's what it is, okay. Press the R to dash forward, cloaked in shadow. Use the cloak to dash through enemies and their attacks without taking damage. Sounds OP, but you'll see in a second. Well, it still is pretty helpful, though. Okay, so what are you about? Oh! Does that mean I can Dream Nail you later when I come back with the Awakened Dream Nail? That's probably what that means. Oh my god, I've never tried that. I'll have to remember that this is here. So now, if we dash, we turn black, but it's... There you go. See, you can see it's on a recharge, so I do it once, and then a couple seconds, boom, there it is. So... Aside from that, it's just normal dashing for a couple little bit. So, you can't spam it, but if you use it strategically, you're invincible now. You can just dash through things. Arcane Egg. These things, these are... Wait, how... Hang on. How the hell have I found an Arcane Egg before I found a King's Idol? How did I do that? I really have not been exploring much of this game at all. Wow, I can't believe I haven't found a single King's Idol yet. Because there's a different hierarchy for how valuable these are. Like, these are like 200 each. These are 200 each. These are 450 each. I think King's Idols are like 800, and the Arcane Eggs are like, what, like 1500, 1200? These things are valuable. So, Yeah, as soon as I get out of here, I'm definitely going to want to, Yeah, no, I was going to think about save warping back to the last bench, but that probably won't work because I just got a new power-up. And they always want you to walk out the old-fashioned way once you get the power-up, so you know how it works. But I only have to dash through one thing, though. Like, that's kind of unnecessary if that is the case. I guess this isn't too long of a walk back, though, but whatever. Well, that was short. That was only 10 minutes. I forgot how kind of barren this place is. Even though it's called the Abyss and there's, like, nothing down here, I forgot how fast this is, so... This is technically an episode, though, because I got the... Well, once I sit down at a bench again, then that's an episode, so... But with this, though, as far as, like, classic Metroidvania stuff is concerned, like, you know, having to get this thing in order to open up these routes and then get this to go here, the actual, like, abilities that are required to just traverse the map, we now have all of them. There is nowhere that we cannot explore right now. There are some places, perhaps, that we shouldn't explore yet because we are... You're very lacking in, like, a lot of upgrades, so things might be very, very difficult to get through, but at this point in the game, though, we can go anywhere. So, that was, like, my first major goal, and it's accomplished now. So now we can... Well, actually, no. Now our next goal is to actually finally, get to all three of these dreamers and get rid of all of them. Oh, I think I just realized also there's also a very important reason for why... Actually, I think you can just save warp back to this bench. I think you can do that, actually, for this one ability. Which is dumb, because this is the one ability where there's actually something you can totally miss, like some story you can totally miss if you choose to do that. I think you can choose to do that for this one, but I won't. I'm going to climb back up the old-fashioned way, because I remember a little dialogue exchange that I probably missed at one point, and that's why I was so surprised to see it one time. But now this is done, we're going to, yeah, go to all three of the dreamers... Take care of them, and then after we take care of the three dreamers, which can be done in any order, we then go to the final boss, back to the Temple of the Black Egg, go to the final boss, and then after we do that, we're gonna get the bad ending, and then go through our whole quest for 101%, because I've been thinking about this more and more, and that, all you have to do to get 101% is just to collect this one single thing. There's a few steps forward, but, like, there's just this one thing you need to get. However, once you get the one thing, though, you encounter the true final boss. And the true final boss is so difficult that I do not want to even attempt to fight it unless I have a maxed out character. So, yeah, basically, after we beat the... Screw it. I gotta stop saying, like, oh, after the final boss, just screw it. It's the Hollow Knight. We fight the Hollow Knight. So, after we beat the Hollow Knight, we're gonna be working on 101% next. That's our next goal. Yeah, Hornet's here. Ghost, I see you have faced the place of your birth, and now drape yourself in the substance of its shadow. Though our strength is born of a similar source, that part of you, that crucial emptiness, I do not share. Though our strength is born of similar source. Is that why so many people thought that Hornet was also made of void? Because she has a similar mask, and she says that line, our strength is born... Like, what does that mean? Because that's like a meme in the Hollow Knight community, where it's like... Hornet is made of void, and everyone, like, loses their minds because, like, apparently it's a common misconception that pisses off fans. I don't know. I only know, like, a tiny little bit about, like, the inner workings of this game. There's so much more I don't understand. Funny, then, that such darkness gives me hope. Within it, I see the chance of change. A difficult journey you would face, but a choice it can create. Prolong our world's stasis or face the heart of its infection. So that's basically, like, basically is Hornet spelling out for you the two endings of this game. Do we want to go through some extra steps to, well, do we just want to just go right into the final boss right now and just fight the Hollow Knights and just simply prolong, just keep the infection at bay a little bit longer, or do some extra steps to actually face the infection head on? Alright, so what else do you have to say? It faced the void and ascends unscathed. Could it unite such vast darkness? Possibly can. I'd urge you to take the harder path, but what end may come, the decision rests with you. Alright. Whoop. I forgot that the R button also activates spells. There's a very random tangent here. There's a very stupid thing with Crypt of the Necrodancer where if you, like, hit, like, up and left at the same time, you activate an item and up and down, or, and, like, it's, like, left and up as an item, left and down as a bomb for no reason. So we miss input things all the time, and there's no good reason for it, because there's also a designated bomb button and a designated spell button, so it just makes zero sense. And I found that out, like, in the menu. It's like, oh, you can turn off this stupid nonsense. You can turn off these shortcuts. Great. before I actually sit down on the bench, I want to point out one funny little thing here now that I have the tram pass. That pass you hold is not for the ghastly machine, the tram. I hope you're not thinking of riding in that grotesque contraption. The thought of a mere machine could attempt what we stags do. Foolish. Very foolish. Okay, Boomer. Alright, that's it for this episode. Map updated. And now we have the Abyss. Fully mapped out because there's really no secret rooms there. It's just that one single thing and that's it. Well, I guess the area to the left is the one optional room technically, but... Ah! I didn't grab the thing that I said I needed to get! Ah, that's a piece of the journal entry, the Hunter's Journal. Screw it, it's not too important. Actually, I have a separate file where the journal is almost complete. Actually, that's all the Agent Basin mapped out. There's not a single thing in this whole entire zone that we could have possibly missed, I don't think. Well, except for that spot we gotta come back to later, we gotta drop 3,000 GU into the Fallout, and actually a lot of things that we missed, but no secret rooms at least that we didn't catch at least. So, oh yeah, next episode, we're going after the Dreamers, actually, so... There's three of them. There is... And we can take them on any order. I'll have to figure out what I'm going to do actually, with these, actually. Let me think. There's Hera the Beast over in Deep Nest. There is, Monomon the Teacher. And, actually, it's in, the Fog Canyon, which we still don't have a map for yet. And then, finally, there is, Lurie and the Watcher in the City of Tears. So those are the three Dreamers. We gotta get to them. Fight a boss for two out of the three of them, and then dream nail the Dreamer. That's our goal. Dream nail all three Dreamers. And that'll open up the final boss. So I'm kinda tempted to see if I can I wonder if I've actually managed to bypass if there's any maps I can buy. Like back in Dirtmouth. Cause I don't know exactly what triggers, like, Cornifer to leave a zone. I think there's a certain order, like a certain route, like other characters, where you see him in these orders, and if you just miss one spot, then it's just... You're just gone forever, you can't get the map there. Let's see if there's any maps that I missed. Oh, the resting grounds. Did I... I don't remember even seeing him there. Any hints of him there. Then again, I pretty much like got there, got the dream nail, and then immediately left. So whatever, I can buy that. What's the point of the tram pin? Like for real? Like there's only two on the whole map, and it's very clear where they are. Also, like you can clearly see like that, like those spots there. Yeah, that's the other tram right there. By the way, is between the Forgotten Crossroads, and Resting Grounds. Then the other tram is down here. Yeah, you can clearly see where they are. You don't need a pin for those. Alright, Bapanada. I'm gonna buy it anyway, though, just to satisfy my OCD. Get the fully complete map. These two things I'm actually not gonna get yet, because I'm gonna be working about those in later episodes, so... Like, so much so that I'm not even going to try to... Yeah. 18 minutes, You know, I think I'm gonna end this episode with me, selling all my stuff, and then, gonna sell my stuff and then buy a whole bunch of things. I'm just gonna, like just go on just some mass upgrades for my character here, and then I'll call it an episode. So, be right back. Alright, back with the shopkeeper. Actually, the short one's got an odd look about it, though vaguely familiar. I've actually never tried him before. Okay. Alright, gotta make a lot of money now. Wanderer's Journal.
Oh, Paul.
A Wanderer's Journal. You have a knack for finding these. Corpses must be frequent on your journey. No doubt your nails create many more. Yeah, some people just know. Like, oh, this is a cold-blooded killer right here.
Oh, Paul.
Another Wanderer's Journal, huh? This journal is of traditional stone type. Text endures well upon it. In its declining age, the city switched from stone to parchment, woven of spider's silk. It's a small tragedy, but the moisture in these towers has rendered most of those texts illegible. A Wanderer's Journal? Have you heard that saying about stone journals? If danger lurks close by and your nails dulled with wear, just swing your journal at your foes with blunt and deadly flare. It's a good one, isn't it? And accurate. They sure have heft to them. I love that mental image of just this little knight just swinging around just a stone brick and just beating people with it. Alright, okay, so. Hollowness Seal. I think I'm at the point where it's like he's... Yep, that's another Hollowness Seal, alright. The shop will be overflowing with these things soon. Gah. I never guessed so many would still be lying around. They're as common as you. If they're as common as you make them seem, maybe I've been offering too much for them. Okay, arcane egg. Ah, this seems like a simple egg, but it's actually a precious relic from before the birth of Hollownest. I'll pay you a small fortune for it. Please sell it to me. 1,200 Dio. Yes. Item sold.
Oh, Paul.
An arcane egg, now? An arcane egg, huh? Now this. This is an ancient thing. These relics are the prize of my profession. There's knowledge hidden within, though it's very difficult, painstaking work to extract. One large understanding can be gleaned, though. This civilization may claim itself the first, but something else did exist within this place before Hollownest. Each egg offers a near glimpse into that forgotten age. So very interesting. Got a lot of money now, and I think the first thing I'm gonna do is go and just buy the next nail upgrade, because I'm here. I think he's just... short walk over there, yeah. Then save warp back to the freaking words. Stag station. Whoop. I love this dash. Nah, not dealing with you. Also, I just remembered another little trick. I was gonna cut this out, but actually, this is worth leaving in. Go all the way up as high as you possibly can. And boom, you're right there. Alright, I forgot how much he charges for this one, though. I think the most expensive, like the final nail upgrade, is like 4,000 Geo, so I can definitely afford this. So you have some pale ore, a rare fine metal. That, give me that ore and some Geo for my efforts, and I'll reforge your nail to make it stronger. That was a sentence I did not read right at all. What else is new? 800, not bad at all, absolutely. As you wish, I'll get to work then. There you go, the reforging is complete. I've added a channel to your nail. It should cut much more efficiently. You'll find it stronger than it used to be. Alright, so... very good. Head out there and test the strength on your foes. Whoopsies, didn't mean to... Oh, down also interact with things? Actually, I probably should have known that, actually. Test the nail on its... Ugh, that's not gonna land. Now that I messed that up, I was gonna say, go out there and test the nail on its foes, and I'd be like, no, I don't think I will. But then I goofed it up, and that would have... That killed the joke. That killed the flow of the joke. See, the worst thing about the effect of crossroads is that you should be able to just go straight down but not with that one path blocked off. Now I gotta find another way around. Oh, hold up. Is this the way of the tram? No, it is not. Okay, good. I guess, well, not bother cutting this out now. There's more things to show. So these guys, they just spit a lot more at you. Shield bros are all the same still. Yeah, these guys are actually pretty much like... Not too much worse, the ones that just shoot stuff at you. I mean, of course, originally they just jumped at you. Yeah, they're not so bad, though. Unlike something else that we're sure to come across eventually. Oop. Can't believe I actually hit... Are there more of these things also? Okay, no, this is where the tram is, okay. I know I'm gonna come across one of these guys in a minute. Oh, there's definitely one down here, yeah. It's worth a shot. Just try dream kneeling everything in this game, basically. There he is. Do not touch them. If you hit them with the nail, they also explode. You just gotta jump out of the way. They just freaking suicide bomb you. I think that's it for the new enemies, though. I think that's all of them. So I'm here just to buy the last charm that I couldn't afford before, and also another charm notch. All right, so long nail. This is what I thought that this freaking thing was when. Wait, the nail wheel's adorable. Okay. Yeah, I was confusing that charm for this one that I got here. Greatly increases the range of the bear's nail. Is that one just this one just better? Because I remember this joke here, like. That nail you wield is adorable, but do you feel sometimes it could feel a little longer? Ho 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 ho. That's a dick joke. That's in this game. So then, only need four more charms to get the final charm notch. Okay, that isn't bad. Keep collecting, as she says. Alright, so we're done here then. Oh, I don't like that. I'm leaving. I just realized that I still haven't used that new nail move I got yet. Still haven't seen it yet. I mean, there's no enemies around here, but whatever. There's a lot to do. Okay, so I'm glowing now. But if I just let go of it, just standing still, nothing happens. Because I really should have gotten the regular charge slash first, whatever. Hold down the Y button, charges up. And while you're dashing, you do a huge attack there. So that's a thing. Probably not going to use it very much, but it's a thing that I have. What more do you have for me, actually? Faring well on your adventure below, well, I had an adventure of my own while you were gone. I don't usually visit the town's graveyard, but I thought I'd go out and visit the grave of an old friend. As I was walking amongst the tombstones, I noticed a strange kind of chanting coming from somewhere nearby. Extremely sinister chanting. I looked around to find its source, and I saw two bright, horrible, huge eyes staring at me from the door of a dark cave. Ah! Heh! I pretended I hadn't heard the voice or seen the eyes and scurried back to town. My friend will have to wait for a little longer for her visits. So he met the little guy that's in there. Things are so much simpler up here. Yeah, no kidding. Well, your town has a population of three people? Four people. And there was... And before I came along, it was just two. It was just the Elder Bug and a Zelda, and that was it. Alright, so... Yeah, I think this is the only shop... Let me think. How many actual shops are in the game? Like, quite literally, it's just... Like, one more thing I gotta buy from Solubrob. Once I have enough charms, that is. One nail upgrade. Actually, two more nail upgrades I gotta buy from the Nailmaster once I... From the Nailsmith once I get more pale ore. Yeah, that's it, actually. I don't think there's anything else I gotta spend money on. Aside from, like, maybe some more toll gates and geo benches or stuff like that. I don't know. So, yeah. Sly, what you got for me? Actually, how am I doing on mask shards and stuff like that? One more mask shard will give me another heart, and two more vessel fragments. Okay. Yeah, let's get this last thing also. Heavy blow. And I'm not buying Sprintmaster because, again, this is technically DLC, and I just... That's just not the way I play this game. I'm gonna do all the base content first, just avoid everything else. Alright, so, yeah, give me the mask shard. Give me another hit. That'll be great. This started out as a short episode, but now it's gone on for 31 minutes. But I probably cut out a lot, though, because I've done a lot of walking in this one. I think, yeah, I think that both these things, he keeps on saying, like, oh, like, this is the last one that I found, and I think there's even, like, one more after this one where he's like, okay, this is the last one, I swear. Yeah, probably can't afford to buy both of these, but I'll get the one. I still haven't gotten a single actual vessel, like, a soul upgrade yet. There's only three in the game, though. I mean, there's a total of 9 vessel fragments total. 900 now, yeah. I dug out another one of these. Turns out I had a complete set. If they didn't give me the creeps, I'd put the pieces together myself. Alright. Well, that's about all the upgrades that we can buy, at least. We gotta go look for the rest of them. And that's for another day. Like I said, taking care of the Dreamers next, and then we'll... beat the Hollow Knight, and then we'll do all the exploring, and that'll be quite a process. So, that's it for now, though. So, next time on Hollow Knights, we're gonna just do that. We're gonna go track down the Dreamers and be on our way to actually finishing the main story of this game. See you guys next time.